In today's Morning Meds, we'll discuss what the Bible thinks about witchcraft. So if you're ready, then let's go. Good morning and welcome back to Morning Meds, where we meditate on God's word in order to tackle everyday issues that we face as Christians. And if you like what you see on Morning Meds, be sure to like, share, and subscribe so we can make it through this life together with the help of God. Most people's view of witchcraft is either fear and trembling or disbelief, while others, who are unclear of what all is included in the term witchcraft, end up participating out of ignorance. Witchcraft is like an umbrella. And underneath that umbrella, we find spiritism, necromancy, fortune telling, sorcery, magic, light workers, and black magic workers, the use of herbs, essential oils, charging crystals or other inanimate objects, and using mind-altering drugs in order to reach a higher state of consciousness or to affect your life or the lives of others, child, it's all witchcraft. Basically, any supernatural experience that God does not endorse is witchcraft.
Is it real?
The most important fact about all of this is that it is real. It can work or manifest. Must we be reminded that the fathers of this earth can give gifts as well? He can disguise himself as an angel of light. So this is real. It is a thing. If not, God would not have made place for it in his word.
So what does the Bible say about witchcraft?
Let's face it. As Christians, there is no gray area. If it's not God, it's the devil. The word of God is crystal clear on the matter. Leviticus mentions multiple times, do not turn to spirits and speaking to the dead. And let's take a look at Galatians chapter 5, verses 21 through 22. Paul literally lays that thing out, okay? Now the works of the flesh are evident: sexual immorality, impurity, sensuality, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, fits of anger, rivalries, dissensions, divisions, envy, drunkenness, orgies, and things like these. I warn you, as I warned you before, that those who do such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. And clearly states that if you participate in these things, you will not inherit the kingdom of God. Now, if you ain't interested in inheriting the kingdom, then this video is not for you. But we cannot be out here praying and saging and shouting and chakra cleansing. It does not make sense. We must leave the supernatural to God. The enemy and all of his subsidiaries are offering a fluffed up, counterfeit version of what spirituality actually is through this idea of God consciousness. But the word of God says there's only one way to God, and that's Jesus Christ. If you have been knowingly participating in witchcraft or any of its subtypes, you must renounce it and repent. All representation of any form of spirituality other than Jesus Christ must be destroyed. Not sold, not given away, but destroyed. Candles, altars, patron saints, charged crystals, anything purchased with the intent to contact spirits or to reach a higher state of consciousness must all be discarded. All of these things may be hard for you to just simply destroy because you spent your money on it, but this is spiritual and you have to make a stand. Get rid of it. the courage to turn right now in the name of Jesus. We know that demons tremble at the name of Jesus. We know that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess in heaven and earth that Jesus Christ is Lord. We ask you, God, to free every person that is watching this video that has been involved in any type of witchcraft, any type of sorcery, any type of magic. God, right now we ask you, Lord, to remove those things. We rebuke those things. We renounce those things in the name of Jesus. We believe you. We believe your word, God. We may have dabbled. They may have dabbled, God, but we come back to you, Lord. We repent. We turn. We come to you. Forgive us, Lord God, and gird us up, Lord, because we know that the enemy is going to come full force. He's going to come so hard to make sure that we will not come back to you and stay on the right track. Lord God, allow your Holy Spirit to gird us up and keep us strong. Allow us to see in your word what you want for us to see and what you want for us to know. We trust your plan and we believe your will. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Version of what spirituality actually is.